Dear students, greeting of the day. I, Dr. Vijay K. Sharma from Anand International College of Engineering, Jaipur, welcomes you all to my lecture on topic powder metallurgy. This topics come under Unit 6 of Manufacturing Process subject. This subject is taught in Mechanical Engineering branch in 4th semester under RTU syllabus. I'm going to cover following topics as per the RTU scheme. The first one is introduction of powder metallurgy process, then properties of powder process products. What is the powder metallurgy process? The details I am going to discuss in this lecture. Thereafter, what are the various powder manufacturing methods? We are going to study these things in this lecture. Then one of the important process, that is sintering process, will be covered here, and advantages and application of powder metallurgy process is also covered. But this lecture one is restricted to first three topics only. The first topic, that is introduction to powder metallurgy process. The first and the foremost information regarding powder metallurgy process is date back to 3000 BC, when Egyptian used powder process for making tools. In the present era, Thomas Alva Edison used tungsten filament in their electric bulb, and this tungsten filament was manufactured using powder metallurgy process. In this process, components can be made by pure metal, by their alloys, or mixture of metallic and non-metallic powders. The commonly used materials in this process are iron, copper, aluminium, nickel, titanium, brass, bronze, steel, and refractory metals. And the products that are manufactured using this process are gears, cams, bushing, cutting tools, piston rings, connecting rods, impellers, etc. Coming to definition part of powder metallurgy, in this the initial thing we required is metal. This metal is converted into the powder form using suitable manufacturing method. Then this powder is again converted in a serviceable metal product. This is the definition. We can say this is the art or science through which the powder is produced, and this powder is converted into the useful or serviceable product. This figure highlights the detail. Here you can see there's the raw powder is there. This raw powder can be of elemental metal, or this can be mixture of two or three metal. Then this raw powder is formed in a particular shape using some mechanical machines and dyes. This formed product doesn't have sufficient strength. This only having the mechanical bonding. To provide metallurgical bonding, this formed product is sintered. Sintered means it is provided some heat and pressure so that mechanical bond of formed product convert into metallurgical bond using surface diffusion. And we are able to get the products like this. Then some basics of powder metallurgy process. This is the highly developed method of manufacturing precision metal parts. In this process, elemental or alloy powders are mixed and then compacted in a die. The resulting shape is sintered in an atmosphere controlled furnace to convert mechanical bonds into metallurgical bond. And this is a process which is also called as near net shape process, in which around 97% of the starting material is used as finished parts. This is also called as chipless process. Considering about the properties of powder metal products, the first and the foremost property the products have is the porosity or permeability in nature. Second thing, the product of complex shapes are possible using this method. If you are able to produce dye of a particular shape, the similar shape products can easily be manufactured using this method. In this method, products made of material that are difficult to machine, means if machinability index of a particular material is high, which is difficult to machine using conventional cutting tools, then by this method we can easily produce parts. Similarly, if particular metal having high melting points, then we also produce the product of this particular metal. Next, products which require the combined property of multiple materials. If two dissimilar metals need to be combined, then they need to be first produced in the form of powder. Then these powders are mixed and we can able to get desirable product that having properties of multiple metals. Means composite materials can be produced using this method. Products in which powder metallurgy produce superior properties. Means by this method we are able to get products which have superior properties, like in case of engine parts where the porosity or permeability is a desirable property, we can easily achieve this sort of product by this method. Then there is some example of powder metal products. By this method we can manufacture gears, cams, cranks, bearings, roller bearing cages, housings, light bulb filaments, sprinkler mechanisms, sprockets, fasteners, electric contacts, cutting tools, and various machinery parts. This is a reference list. There are a lot of other products that can be manufactured using this method. Coming to the most important topic of this lecture, that is powder metallurgy steps. And this is the question that is generally asked in examination point of view also. And these steps are, first one is production of powder metal, and this is also known as a raw material that we are going to use here. Second one is the mixing of this raw material. Third one, this pre-mixed material is provided a shape using some mechanical machines, presses or dies, that is known as forming, and this form component is then provided some heat to convert mechanical bond into metallurgical bond, that is known as sintering, and finally some optional operations are carried out to get desirable property in a particular product. This figure shows the detail of this process. Here we can see that the complete process is divided into few steps. Here the initial step, the first thing, we required raw materials. This raw material can be an elemental metal or it can be alloy of metal powders. Then some additives are also added here. These additives can be graphite and dye lubricants. Why these are added? These are added for the two reasons. First thing, they will reduce friction between metal powders, and second, they are useful when the dye product is ejected from the dye. They will provide ease in this process. Then these both will be added and mixed in a mixer, or they are blended together to get homogeneous mixture. Why this homogeneous mixture is important? The mixing is important because we are able to get a mixture that having less porosity, so we are able to get a component which have high density. When we get this mixture, when we complete this mixing process, we move for the forming process. Forming is a process in which a desired shape of component is given. There are two methods for that. One is known as hot compaction and second is known as cold compaction. As the name suggests, in the hot compaction case, the heating is also carried out simultaneously with the process. There are total three or four processes. One is known as isostatic extrusion. Second one is known as die compacting. Third one is spraying, and fourth one is pressure sintering, pressureless sintering. In isostatic extrusion, where isostatic means there is having the equal process, equal pressure in each direction, that is known as isostatic, and extrusion is the process, you already know how it is carried out. Then die compacting, in which the material is mixed, material is put in the die and the compaction pressure is applied with heat. Thereafter, the third one is spraying, in which the powder, mixing powder, is spread in the spray form, and they get going layer by layer manufacturing will be there. And in the last case, that is pressureless sintering, in which the pressure is not applied, and the simple process is known as pressureless sintering. Although the sintering required two things, pressure as well as heat. Heat is there, but in pressureless sintering, the only thing that we doesn't apply any sort of pressure. Then in case of cold compaction, the processes are carried out using die compacting, isostatic rolling, injection molding, and slip casting. In die compacting, the material is fed between the dies and then press against each other. So we are able to get the die product. Isostatic rolling is similar to the isostatic extrusion. Here the process replaces only extrusion to the rolling. Both will be used for the metal components. Then injection molding is a process of compaction in which we get plastic or resin products. And in case of slip casting, we get ceramic products like ports and other. Then once we get this cold compaction product, which doesn't having sufficient strength, it will in the green, it is having in the green state, where it can easily be breakable by the hand pressure. Then the next process, sintering, is carried out. Sintering is carried out using some furnaces. These furnaces can be atmospheric furnaces, or it can be vacuum furnaces. It having the high temperature. But this high temperature is not so much enough, so much high that the metal is converted into liquid form. Means only certain temperature is high up to certain level, so that the metal surface only get diffusion, not the entire metal is converted into the liquidation form. This is known as sintering process. After that, some optional operations are carried out. These optional operations are, as the name suggests, are optional in nature. They are not compulsorily done for each product. Few are required in particular product. These can be divided into two parts. One is known as the optional manufacturing steps, and second is known as optional finishing steps. In optional manufacturing steps, the first three, repressing, coining, and sizing. These are used to get dimensional accuracy in a component. If a component is not dimensionally accurate, then we require repressing, coining, and sizing. So we are able to get the product in exact dimension or in the desired dimension. Thereafter, three more processes are there: recentering, forging, and re-rolling. These three are used to provide strength by increasing density of the product. And the last one, that is known as metal infiltration. This is a process where pores of the product are filled by liquid metal. And how these pores are filled? By the capillary action of the metal. And why this process is carried out? Due to increase toughness and strength of a particular component. If come to the optional finishing steps, then machining is a first process. In case of machining, if a component having certain undercuts that are not produced during die compaction step, then secondary operations are required. If we have to produce some holes, if we have to produce some taping, some chamfering operation, such small machining can be carried out at later stage due to economical reasons. Thereafter, heat treating and steam treating are the two processes. They are used to increase the properties of a particular product. Similarly, plating is one of the processes in which a layer of particular metal can be put on a particular product. Like we want to put a zinc coating, nickel coating, gold coating, or other metal coating, then this particular product is dipped inside the liquid bath of this particular metal, and we are able to get the product with a new surface, that is known as plating. Then tumbling is a surface finishing process where the product is going to be tumbled in a particular chamber to get the desired surface finish. Then in short pinning process, the product is put in front of the balls at the pins, and their stresses are relieved at this stage, and the product is getting more fatigue strength. There are two more processes remaining. One is known as plastic impregnation, and second is oil impregnation. So the both of the process are quite similar with the metal infiltration. In this process, the product is dipped inside a molten plastic bath, then it is known as plastic impregnation. And if the product is dipped in an oil bath, then it is known as oil impregnation. And after that, we are able to get a finished product that is serviceable. So this is the complete step of powder metallurgy process. I think you have gone through everything, and thank you. I am going to end my lecture for today. Have a nice day.